or when you're painting a door, it just makes it easier to have the handles removed. I'm just painting to this edge here. So you just remove those two screws. So this is a steel door. What I like to do with these, I'll just set that there for now. What I like to do is just use a bit of sandpaper. This is 120 grit. Just want to scuff up the surface. Not pressing very hard, just lightly. That'll just help with the adhesion. Just with some warm water. So after that's wiped down, just want this to be nice and dry. I'd give it like 15-20 minutes. Because it's a steel door, it'll dry quick. Then we will put a coat of primer on it. It's a steel door. I always think it is a good idea just to put a coat of primer, a good primer, first before applying your first coat of the door and trim paint. Okay, after the door is nice and dry, then what we want to do is just start with a coat of primer. I like to just do the brushing first and the rolling after. You don't want to put on too heavy, so really stretch it out. You just need a liter for something this, like this, just a door. You want to be cautious of any buildup in areas like that. You get it too heavy in this area, it'll just have a run down there. You want to make sure you do the rolling before this paint starts to set up. It'll just blend better. Okay, and I wouldn't worry about here. I'll show you what I do. So I like to use these small 4-inch roller sleeves for doors. I generally won't use these for a door. I have in the past, but these just seem to spread it out a lot nicer. Once again, you don't want a lot on the roller. You want to just have a nice thin coat of primer. So I'll start at the bottom because this paint I did with the brush still wet. And it'll just blend it nice. You want to just leave this primer for an hour or two, maybe 2 hours be better, before you apply your first coat of the door paint. Oops. Okay, applying the first coat to the door of the door and trim paint. Now this is more than what I need for the door, but I'll be doing other doors and trim also today. So you just want to do the same thing that you did with the priming. Start out with your brushing first. You'll be putting two coats on of this white color, so don't have to put it on super thick first coat. Just want to go down this side where the hinges are with the brush. First coat will not look great. The second coat will give it a much better finish. So if you're thinking it doesn't look quite right, don't put more on than you need to. The second coat, two thin coats is all you need, and then it'll look very good and a nice smooth finish. So while this is still wet, you want to get rolling. For this, once again, I use the 4-inch roller sleeve. Best to start at the bottom where you started with the brushwork. You don't want this to get set up before you can blend it in. If you go too heavy, on your brushwork, you'll get runs down there, and you don't want that. It won't look very good. Now you want to give that more time to dry than the primer. So I'd say go by what the directions of the can says. But generally I'll leave it for 6 hours before I put the second coat, the last coat on. But yeah, that looks good. I'm just gonna leave it. Time for last coat on the door. So things are looking pretty good. Light third coat just to ensure that it's really covered well. For this, you want to just follow the same steps as you did for the first and second coat. Sometimes with white paint, it just requires a little bit extra just to have really nice coverage. I did put a third coat on this part before I put the handle back on. So that's done. But yeah, this last coat is gonna just finish things up nicely.